formal society helmet mask. It's actually worn on top of the head or down a little bit as if it were a helmet. And it came into the museum's permanent collection in 1997 as a gift. And before that, while it was still in the possession of the previous owner, the exhibition was in an the mask was in an exhibition called Animals in African Art. And at the time, the person, the scholar who wrote about it, described it as the face of fear. And it is scary. I mean, it would be even scarier if this were dark in the room and you were maybe seeing, you know, seeing it by firelight as it performs in the village. That is, on the few occasions that it comes out and the public gets to see it. But I'm getting ahead of myself. So anyway, we acquired the mask, and I remember when I wrote about it in the 2009 book, I did my research, but we didn't know as much now as we knew about it then. And I looked at the mask and I thought immediately, as did other people, that it was a Sanufo mask that had been messed with, that had come into a contact with a neighboring people, perhaps. Most likely the Bamana who live in Mali, which is, where's the map? Who live over here. And that it makes perfect sense to me, you know, after I thought about it and studied and did everything I could. This is where these people, this is their territory. They live in the Ivory Coast, they live in Mali, they live in Burkina Faso, and I've already mentioned a few places that they live. It happens that the mask was actually acquired, was purchased in Burkina Faso. And it was, as we've known, Fran told you, it's a contemporary mask based on what we know about some of the materials. But it was probably made maybe in the 70s at the latest. Burkina Faso is a little drier than some other areas of West Africa. But most things, most wooden things, don't last more than 25, 30, 40 years. So it's not all that old, but what else does that tell you? That this is a contemporary phenomenon, that the Como was alive and well at some point. Why did the owner give it up? Why? I don't really know. But the person may have converted to Islam or Christianity. And when you have to put Como before everything, even your wife and your children, then that's not going to be compatible with being Christian or belonging to any organized religion. Maybe there was no one to carry on the tradition, because Como masks are not inherited. When you become a member of Como, then you have to start from scratch, commission a sculptor to carve the mask, and then as the owner, you get to make it look like this. You get to say, I'm a wealthy man, I can afford to go to the market and buy European wine glasses that I will break and use the base as eyes for my mask. I'm gonna decorate it with cowrie shells, because in the old days, cowries were currency. So you're looking at my bank account. You see me coming. Mirrors. Yeah, mirrors may be deflecting all the things in the environment, but mirrors are an important object too, or objects. As well. So the mask is an expression of the owner.